Welcome to a brief overview of the major changes you can expect to see in Desire to Learn version 10.1, brought to you by UWM's Learning Technology Center. Please keep in mind that this is just a sneak peek. More detailed help documentation will be available under Need Help Using D2L on your D2L My Home page. The first change coming to D2L 10.1 is a major one. The content area has been significantly redesigned to be more streamlined. When you first go to Content, you'll see that View Content and Manage Content have been combined into a single interface. Modules show up along the left, and you can view topics within modules by clicking on the module names. One great aspect of this redesign is the ability to provide a course overview, as well as modular descriptions, directly in the content area, which means that you can embed video, audio, and images right in content. The next great addition to D2L 10.1 is the ability to drag and drop. Yep, it's here. You can now drag and drop files directly from your desktop into anywhere you typically upload files. For example, I've added a file to my content area simply by grabbing it from my desktop and dropping it in the content area. You can also reorder items in your content area using the drag and drop feature. The User Progress tool, which can be accessed via the class list, has been changed in D2L 10.1 to provide student information quickly and more easily. As an instructor, you can also customize your view of user progress. Another nice change coming in D2L 10.1 is the Document Viewer. The Document Viewer in Content allows instructors and students to view Word documents and PowerPoint files right in D2L without having to download them. For those of you who use discussion forums extensively, you might like that in D2L 10.1, you can now hide topics in your discussion area, making it easier to navigate through long lists of discussion forums. You can even see, at a glance, how many students have posted in each topic. Do you ever have students asking to submit assignments to the Dropbox after the due date? I know I do. In D2L 10.1, you can now let students upload files after the due date without giving them special access to the Dropbox. Simply set a due date and an end date under Restrictions. The due date indicates when the assignment is due, and the end date marks the final time students can upload files. Anything submitted after the due date is marked late. We all make mistakes. One mistake you never wanted to make before D2L 10.1 was accidentally deleting gradebook items. In the new version, however, you can bring back deleted grade items with a few simple clicks. Student grade data will return as well. Thank you for viewing our video on D2L version 10.1. If you have any questions, please feel free to contact us at the Learning Technology Center.